interview number one. 5-day canoe trip in Temagami, starting at Anima-Nipissing, going through the series of lakes, including Eagle, Walsh, Lady Evelyn. Weather was fantastic all the way through. Wind conditions were favorable in almost all cases. And the temperature wasn't so hot to kill you, but it was certainly warm enough that you could go for a nice swim. Henry survived every portage, much to his own personal disbelief.
And your regret.
And I would have to say that though it was one of the toughest trips for a 5-day journey, it was certainly one of the more rewarding. The portages, as advertised, were either longer than advertised, easier than advertised, or more difficult than advertised. Few were as explained in the guide, but that's how it goes. Some interesting rocks, some interesting sections of muddy track, and a few logs that had to be traversed with a balancing act. But all in all, we were able to keep our pace going. Once we figured out the method of hauling our stuff through the forest without overburdening arms and legs, it seemed to speed up the traverse of the portage. And I have to say that not seeing a drop of rain is a magical thing on any canoe trip. And so this has to be considered 100% success. Seen lots of things, caught almost no fish, although the efforts were minimal. And human traffic was negligible to near zero in the interior. One canoe party in the Anima-Nipissing area, and that's it. That's all we saw. And that's it for my part.
Yeah, right there. So this is my interview for just leaving the campsite on the last day of our 5-day trip through Temagami, the Eagle Lake trip. And it's been a really challenging, physically challenging trip with lots of portages, but I do like the mixture of the portages along with the water. The portages are far rougher than what you'd expect in Algonquin, and so you have to kind of think of that when you're planning it. But we made some excellent progress as we got a little more efficient on how to handle things through the portage, and we didn't have to triple, so it was really good that way. And yet at the same time, I think we were reasonably comfortable with what we were able to take with us, and in the sense of food and other comforts and so on. The scenery through here is spectacular. The lakes are so clear, you can see easily 20, 30 feet down in many cases. And the swimming after a long day of traveling is really one of the more special parts of the day. I think that this is probably one of the more rewarding trips I've ever done in the sense of an outdoor loop trip. And it's a remarkable set of scenery, because again, we haven't seen the people really in 4 days. And, you know, not even to compete for campsites and all of that, it's just been really, really nice. And so I really appreciate being able to go on this trip and be part of this, because it's been really special. Hopefully we'll have a good paddle from here out to the Mowat Landing and on our way from there. So that's it from Lady Evelyn.
Take her for granted. She had a hard time. Don't be is understanding. I play with the mind. Treat us so tenderly. She is lonely.